Today's the 4th of July. Another June has gone by. And when they light up our town, I just think what a waste of gunpowder and sky.
Happy Independence Day, everybody. Hello and welcome to Consolevania Independence Day. In this special, we're only going to be covering independent games for you. Now, bear in mind that we can't cover all independent games because there's too many of them. Would you like to say something, Robert?
Fireworks! Aye, a lot of independent games, beginning to end, we're going to shoot them all. And we're going to shoot this episode all in one day because we want to embrace the indie sensibility. So, all in one day, this is getting shot. What time's it, Ryan? About 8 o'clock at night?
8 o'clock, we're just up.
All right, don't bother. Right.
Want to get something to eat?
Fuck it, aye, man.
Oh, baby, I wonder if when you are older someday, you'll wake up and say, my God, I should have told her, what would it be? But now here I am and the world's gotten colder.
Naked War comes from the Pickford brothers. For those of you in the know, yes, those Pickford brothers have been making games now for nigh on 40 years. So well done, lads, yous are doing well, yous are looking good on it.
Not really, though.
What is Naked War, Ryan? Well, I'm glad you asked, because I was just about to move on to that. For those of you who like to stalk myself and Robert, you might recognise this from some other thing that we made where we covered it on that we can't talk about. That's an interesting story, isn't it? Naked War is a turn-based, two-player strategy game, but with a twist. Because when you're losing, your clothes fire off. In the game, I mean, that's no the twist. And that's no a new joke I told there. The twist is, this game's played via email, which means you take your turn, right, you make your moves, you press OK in the game, right, and it emails it to somebody else, to your opponent, who is, like, somewhere else in the world. I can't get my head around it, it's fucking amazing. I mean, it's no use to Michael Caine, that function, but still, for a wee fly game at your work, you know, pretty handy stuff. Look at this. Look, there's no call for that, is there? He'll get his, listeners. Don't you worry. He'll get his. As I was saying, Naked War's a great game for playing on the fly. That's its nature. You can play entirely at your own leisure. You can play it intensively, if you like. Or you can steal a wee shot when nobody's looking. When that fat cow you're sitting next to's went to the toilet, you can have a wee shot in Naked War. Maybe have a wee wank if there's enough time. Or maybe just a shot in Naked War. You prude. Me, myself, as you know, I've got plenty of time in my hands, so I've been playing this quite intensively for a wee while, and my reading of what Naked War was might strike a chord with some of you, because when I saw it for the first time, it worked in three stages, kind of. When I saw it for the first time, I thought, right, I get it, I've seen things like this before, I understand. And then I played it once, and I thought, right, I get it, right, played things like this before. But I didn't get it, and neither will you until you've played it a wee while. I don't know how they managed it, they're dabbling in the dark arts again, but this game delivers what it says on their site it should deliver. You can pick it up, and you'll enjoy it for a wee while. You'll get beasted more than lately, but you'll enjoy it. But it's only once you've been beasted a few times that you'll start to realise the mistakes you were making. You'll realise that you haven't been managing your moves properly, you haven't been using the power-ups properly, and most importantly, you haven't been keeping an eye on the doofers, because that's how you win, you collect all the doofers. It's once I took all that on board that I entered that third stage I was talking about, and I realised, this is a fucking strategy game. And not just a strategy game, a really good one, because once you're more aware of what you're doing, and if you're playing against somebody else that knows what they're doing, that's when you start to see a wee flicker of genius. The game becomes more than the sum of its parts. It's been built, Naked War, but the players make the game. Each individual map with each individual player is different. And because of the way the game's designed, if a player's good enough and smart enough, they can be on the brink of defeat and still battle their way back. That's what I mean about it. You and the other player write your own storyline. It's one of the games that, when it's finished, you play the game over and over again in your head. There are some things in Naked War I don't particularly care for. Using demobbed guys to block your opponent's path or vehicle jumping to heal yourself feels a wee bit like you're exploiting the game. But who am I to say? But a fat poof. News in brief is, I love Naked War. I love it like a big gay. It's a fucking gem. A cracker. Right now it's at the beta stage, but that shouldn't stop you signing up, so get it done. Here's a word for one of the makers, John Pickford.
Hello, Scotland.
Hooray!
Oh, it's very nice, isn't it?
It's lovely.
What's that here?
What?
They're done.
Oh, but
what?
It's not happened yet.
Oh, fuck, it's the 4th of July. Oh, they'll no bloody notice.
Yeah, probably no.
Nah, listen, see if you're going to go into this forest.
Uh-huh.
We should probably go back and get the car, because it's a bit of a hike.
That's fucking magic. Well, we probably should do that.
Let's do that. Let's go back and get the car.
Alright.
Well, in this direction.
Aye, because that's where we came from.
Aye. I'll cut there.
Well, it's actually on the other one.
Hi Kenny, I love playing my Atari Lynx, but my problem is that my batteries keep dying. Do you have any recommendations for Atari Lynx battery packs?
Aye, I've got a battery for you. I stole it from your ma's vibrator, yes. Come on.
Kenny, I'm rubbish at spy versus spy. Have you got any hints?
Why didn't you answer me this, dickhead? See when I was spying on your daggy in your ma gobble? Why was she chanting my name? Kenny, Kenny, Kenny!
Terran Alliance, I'm requesting permission to land. Coming in coordinates 473.976. Carrying cargo, Tyrellian crystals. Landing fortress.
What the fuck, right? My program started.
Right, just shut up and listen. This is Galactic Civilizations 2. Right, it's a strategy game on the PC. Okay, got it. You can choose what kind of universe you want to play in. You can play in a wee one or you can play in a big one. You can customize it. You can choose which races you want to play with. You can choose which race you want to go or what races you want to compete against in a race to rule the universe. You can even set wee custom guys. Look at the Daleks. Extraordinary! You can even import JPEGs and stick your own big ugly fat fuck he's let his cell go face into the game. Look, here's Fat Rab Tiger Mask Girl. Now that's a fucking race you should be proud to be part of. Check the scale of this game. Look, here's one of my ships. And we're zooming out, 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 and we're zooming out. And I know what yous are thinking, oh Rab, this looks like one of these fucking boring games I need to play for hours and hours and hours. And well, sometimes it is. But, isn't it boring? Even though you're micromanaging your planets and building farms and all that stuff that sounds boring when I'm telling you about it, it's no boring. It's even exciting. Now I know all you graphic whores out there are all thinking this game looks duff, Rab, have you lost your nuts? No. Look, there's even wee bits of FMV stuck in there to keep yous happy. Well, guys like me, intelligent guys, are happy with all the research trees and developing all the dingles and the dongles and all that kind of stuff. And robots telling me that space militarization is fucking perfected. Galactic Civilizations 2 differs for a lot of these strategy games in that it has a constant sense of dramatic drive. You're always feeling that there's somebody just breathing down your neck, you're always feeling that you should be pushing forward, and you always have to be changing your approach to playing the game. You have to think, should I be expanding in this direction, or should I be expanding in that direction? They've developed this, should I develop that, should I trade this with them? And you can even speak with these assholes as well. Look, why the long face? I said, because he's got a long face. There isn't actually the option to say that. There should be. Tell me this, are you a Lego man? I should rephrase that. Do you like Lego? Are you a Lego man? One of the most fun aspects of the game is the fact that you can customise and build your own ships, and you could spend ages doing this, building big fancy ships and all that, but I couldn't be fucked, so I just stuck a big fucking tail on it with neon shining at it. Yeehaw! I don't know, miss this wee beauty when I'm next to it dogging in Strathclyde Park, eh? All in all, we're talking about a game that's got everything going for it. Beautifully designed, loads of legs, absolutely massive, beautifully written. The game's so good that I can't really think of a criticism other than there's no multiplayer, and I'm not really bothered about that. So, the best strategy game on the PC. Even better than the strategy game of working out where to hide your porn folder on your hard drive. Ah, me casa eh too, casa. Go and fill your boots.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen! This is us out in the beautiful forest where Ryan buried the Coathanger microphone from last series, do you remember very much?
Sorry about that, ladies and gentlemen. I know he's liked that Coathanger mic and everything. I was also sick as well, and a wee bit of poo getting out of my bum.
That makes it feel a bit better, doesn't it? So, we're going to find the Coathanger microphone so we can all celebrate the history of Consolevania together. That'd be nice, wouldn't it?
No, it's quite exciting, that idea, actually, because what? It doesn't fill up with the show, because we've not got enough stuff.
It's a bit of padding, isn't it, folks? So, here we are in the forest. It's the 7th of July.
The 4th of July.
4th of July. We're pissing the rain. Let's go and see if we can find it!
You know, I actually thought I was going to die in that scene. So the curse came back again. The curse of people dying and being injured. I mean, she slept with hundreds. So she'd been sleeping with hundreds of men.
Oh, in the Resi special, me and Brian sprung the Overblood review on Ryan, and Ryan's face was a picture, so it's...
And it's a lovely moment, isn't it? Don't sulk!
We had a party after the Christmas episode in 2004. I don't think Brian made it.
And there's another party which I didn't go to. I kept away from it. An extra died at the party, choking on his food. It was in episode 4 in which I do my nut.
Oh, episode 4 when we were filming the Gacy bit. Ryan decided that it'd be a good idea to put deep heat in Brian's underpants.
And I felt slightly panicky that I was going to die.
I still don't think he's forgiven me for that.
I'm not going to have him killed or anything, you know.
Oh, aye. Fine.
Was it aye? I suppose I'm quite happy with it, aye.
And I just think, not because I'm any, I think it's the best series ever I've ever seen. I'm going to be objective. I'm too bloody old man, too long in the tooth, have that kind of vanity. The whole standard by everybody in the teamwork, it is on its own.
You can't please everybody. There's always going to be critics. So if people don't like it, you know, it's up to themselves. You can't get tied up with it.
Take them away! I mean, they're going to be vaporised. They're going to be vaporised. Great direction, great production. Staff, make, wardrobe, outstanding cast that worked as a team. And I think it's as near perfection as you can get. I think we all got it together right. And I think that God looks down on a great team and smiles with satisfaction and says, that is it, that's enough. They're all going to die horribly.
You've done it all.
Right, that's me off.
Where are you off to?
I'm away on my cruise I've got planned.
What cruise?
The cruise for my holiday. I've got a right, I'm away.
I want to go on a cruise.
Well, that's just up into it. Right, see you later.
Oh, very good.
nice.
Just like my room, just like I requested. Oh, gonna have a good time here.
What are you doing here? I thought you were meant to be making the show.
I'm just on a wee cruise, having a nice wee holiday.
It's not like you to go on a murder cruise.
What's a murder cruise?
You go on a cruise, and I'll murder you.
The ship comes from outer light and it's distributed using steam. No, the gaseous substance, that wouldn't work, obviously. That's stupid even suggesting that. This is a kind of exclusive for Consolevania because we are one of the first to review the game. That's very trusting of the boys at Outer Light, isn't it? The silly, silly boys. Here's what you do in the ship. You're on a ship, right, and you wake up and you find a weapon and you go and find your quarry and you do them in. That's it. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. Enjoy the footage. Bye. Well, obviously there's a wee bit more to it. For you see, the ship is an online game. See, the person you're hunting, your quarry, stitch that, is a person. I mean, a human person. And not only is that person that you're hunting a human person, but the person who's hunting you is a human person. Ah ha 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 ha! So now you see that while you're being a sneaky killer type, you have to be in your guard. Just let me hear. Well, maybe not quite like me. Although there is something to be said for acting like a glitchy maniac, because it helps you blend in with a non-player character. What the fuck? A leaking thumb or something that guy had? That's a new one, they must have just put that in. But aye, acting like non-player characters, trying to blend in, because the non-player characters are just as sus as everybody else. Check this one out, check to see if I'm following them. Being on the ship's pretty much like being in my local. You go in, everybody expects to get stabbed, but you want to see the bastard's face before he does it to you. So being on your lonesome, on the ship, surrounded by very, very suspect characters, all acting like fucking nutcases, builds a nice wee atmosphere about it. And it's not just as simple as finding the person to kill or stopping yourself from being killed. See the icons down the left? Oh, hold on. Oh, she's got a big fucking mallet. A mallet against a fucking straight light. That's cheating. But aye, I was saying, it's no all just about the killing and the no being killed. Because if you're more successful and you're killing people, you have to keep your character content. If you see the icons on the left hand side, my character's starving. And I think a wee bit bored that icon is. Aye, that means I need to entertain her in some way. Oh, nane of that, you cheeky boys, what are you thinking? That's why she's got a cloud above her head, did you see it there? Because she's miserable as fuck. There are other modes in the ship that you can play other than Hunter. There's Elimination, which is just as good, just as much fun, and I hate that poster, it gives me the heebie-jeebies. And Deathmatch, which goes against the grain slightly of what the ship's supposed to be like, so I never really enjoyed it as much. This is what you do when you kill somebody, change your clays. And they can't find you easily. That looks like quite good fun actually, I think I'll have some of that. Get in there. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, for fuck's sake. Listen to this. Sounds like you're fat maw. Played in the right way with the right group of people, the ship is quite an oh, fucking crap myself there. See what I mean? I'm so on edge that Darren Brown scared me. And you know how friendly he is. I'll get the chance to spit it out eventually. Listen to me, I'm like your fat mono. Pay any attention, I don't really mean it, honestly. Yes, played with the right group of people, playing in the right way, the ship is very atmospheric, a really good romp. But that's what's making me slightly nervous, because the game's not been released yet, so I can't really gauge what the community of players is going to be like, whether there's going to be a bunch of, check this one out, you're not fooling anybody, mate. I can't tell whether, maybe that's why Deathmatch is there, I never thought of that actually, maybe Deathmatch is there to try and water down the wankers that don't know how to play the game properly. Anyway, you should probably buy it, because it's dead cheap. Bastard.
Any luck finding the old coat hanger?
I can't find it. I found my sack and everything, but I can't find the coat hanger.
Listen, don't you get upset about it, come and sit down. And let your old pal play a wee tune, huh? Come on, this is what you do in a forest, isn't it, ladies and gentlemen?
Motherfucker. Motherfucker.
Bullet Candy looks just like all the shoot-em-ups we used to play in the Spectrum and Commodore 64 looked inside our minds. And you remember when your old dad would be stoning over you, giving you disapproving glares as you started screaming when you were playing that Spectrum game, going, "Oh, the pretty lights!" And he thought you were having a seizure because you were imagining this, and now it's here on your PC screen for download and cheap buyage. And it's a very, very good game. Retro-styled, very difficult, plenty of challenge, plenty to get your teeth into, a bit of high score rivalry with your boyfriend or your girlfriend. This is exactly the type of game that should be appearing on Xbox Live Arcade alongside Geometry Wars. So come on, J. Allard, get the finger out of Reggie's arse. Oh, the pretty fireworks of death. Narbacular Drop was made by a bunch of student smart arse bastards, and it's a good time to talk about Narbacular Drop because Prey's just coming out, and Prey's got all that portal stuff happening, so does this, but this kinda does it better. See, you can create a blue portal and you can create a red portal. Blue leads to red and red leads to blue and vice versa. What does that mean? It means lots of puzzles where Robert feels sick because he can see himself through holes that he shouldn't be able to see himself in. When was the last time you looked through a hole and felt sick? When you were spying through a glory hole and somebody jabbed their cock in your eye, probably, a bender. Check Nero out. Nero, nothing to do with the chocolate bar Aero, by the way, is a very, very clever game about programming robots' AI, and you program their AI by, like, training them, just like you would train a dog, like offering them a bone, but no, like, the robot equivalent to a bone, like an oil bone, and or the wee guys, you send them out to fight each other, and other people can train up their own AIs and send it out. I'm just stalling for time here, I've not played it, it's too complicated. Let's get back on to some shooting. Here's a great shooting game. It's called Tremulous, and I think it's absolutely tremendulous. And it features an iron brew machine. The only way this game could appeal more to the Scots is if it featured a 16-year-old slapper out of her nut on Alka Pops, slapping porridge onto her tits and firing her Willy Annuals out of her fanny. But boy, this game has got it going on. Two teams, a team of humans and a team of aliens, they go against each other, laying siege to each other's bases. What else do you need? I'll tell you. It'd be good if it was free, wouldn't it, folks? Well, it is free! So what are you waiting for? Get downloading it, and you can play me, and the Ryan, and the Mad Kenny, and the Joanne, and everything, and we're all playing Tremulous, because it's tremendulous. BreakQuest is a prime example of why indie games are so good, because often it's like old ideas that work, but infused with so much personal style. So here we've got a breakout Arkanoid-style game that allows you to go up against Space Invaders, and you know what Space Invaders make us games fans feel like? Emotional! And here's a segment where you just hit beautiful wee chiming blocks that are suspended in the air on wires, and here's you bouncing your boss against a big fiery devil, and all like that, don't we, folks? Oh, and look at all these wee dots that called your maw a cow, take them out. Oh, and look at these dots! These dots make your eyes go off funny. 1 minute they're white, the next minute they're black, the next minute they're white. Ah, oh, it's like Al Jolson's career in video game form. Now, you can't finish any indie roundup without talking about New Star Soccer 3, which is one of the best indie games out there just now. Now, I'm talking about really, really good. You're one player in a team. It's a simulation of one player's life in a team, which means you fought with your girlfriend and your family and you never get a fucking game and you're training poorly, and because of that, you hate your team, and that's what it must be like for real players. That's why we hate them so much, the spoilt bastards. They hate the team. It's all about me. What a great game. Emotional. Indie games. Don't listen to us. Download them and try them yourself. I'll see you back and it makes you try, make you try, make you try, make
you. Oh, Tony, how you doing, mate? 6-page feature about indie games? I'd love to, mate. Oh, that's the spirit of NSJ. I think I know how to start it already. But what would Percy Shelley say about indie games? Then she lay down in the street, right before the horse's feet, expecting with a patient eye, murder, fraud, and anarchy. Hello? Tony?
Not everyone understands new school journalism, you know what I mean? But I can explain it. It's like the method. Robert De Niro understands what I'm talking about, yeah? Al Pacino, Scarface himself, yeah? He understands. Danny Glover, of course he understands. So I was gonna steep myself in indie culture, read indie comic books, watch those indie films. And I was going to listen to some of that obscure indie music. Yeah? Taking it to the streets. It's not just about playing the indie games for me. I got to live the indie lifestyle, yeah? I got to fight the fight.
NSJ, mate, yeah? Crush the video game fascist, yeah? New school journalism, support interactive arts. Analysis. New school journalism, crush a video game fascist, yeah? Oh, come on, fight the power, yeah? And it's a movement, it's a spiritual movement more than anything else, you know what I mean? So if you can say NSJ for me and you can support, when you see the adverts for the video games, the big corporate video games, you turn your back on that, you support the independent interactive arts, yeah? And support NSJ, so if you can take that for me, a little bit of information, and say NSJ for me, mate, yeah? Fantastic, yeah? Fantastic.
The night before the deadline, I have a dream. In that dream, a man is suffering for the sins of all those who don't put their soul into what they write. That man is me. And they'll keep trying to break me down, I know they will. But NSJ is a movement that won't stop. And I'll keep telling my story. It's the greatest story ever told.
Where did you put it?
I don't remember.
That's your history you've lost.
I said I'm sorry.
A history of past.
Oh, Rob. Found it. I'm not kidding. No, I found it.
Oh, there you go, mate. I don't believe it.
It's the same one.
Oh, my God. What are memories? Memories are flooding back. Can I touch it? Is it real?
Are you sorry?
Can I touch it?
Are you sorry?
I'm sorry. Can I touch it?
On you go.